I'm David McLaughlin. I live on Sherburn Road and I'm 12. In summer we come down, catch butterflies, and we take them back up, put them in a big hut thing.
In 2005, 11-year-old David Glockman, Glocky to his friends, told us what his dreams were for the countryside around his home on the Sherburn Road housing estate in Durham City. Like many Durham City young people who live on the estate or the surrounding pit villages, he saw himself as much a country lad as a town dweller, with the countryside as his backyard.
The defining element, really, and something which actually defines the castle and cathedral, is the river and the river valley and that incised meander. It came to our attention, really, that a lot of the connections had been severed for all sorts of reasons: the pit closures, the fact that the social breakdown that followed that, etc., etc., etc. Yet within the Durham, the Weir Valley, the River Valley, there were some real gems, and there were communities and people up to activities which really were not given a wider canvas, and that tied back really into our view of the city. And there were some real gems which could be introduced, so that it wasn't all about the castle and the cathedral and the marketplace and the new development. It was about people's role in developing it and the community's role within the River Valley.
The Durham Necklace Park was born out of this local desire for access. It is an unprecedented concept and is known as the Ephemeral Park. 12 River Weir linked miles of pathways, land and spaces and places. This park is environmentally lightest of touch, with no mark being made at any time. Based on deals and arrangements, its boundaries or definitions are not fixed. No money exchanges hands. No land has been purchased. It is a major community project and has become one of the most city's principal strategies for the future, attracting funding for environmental and community major projects, and capturing the imagination of research bodies, environmental agencies, and cultural bodies and businesses. Mapping the Necklace was funded by .07 as a project to get people moving into and around their own countryside, online or on foot, recording and sharing their observations and experiences through innovative forms of mapping. The experiment was also to help test sustainable tourism in the region. No marks, no emissions, no cost. Return as often as you want, online or on foot.
Senor Rico Rodriguez Cayman's home was in an alley. The local term is Benal, and Rico usually called it a callejon, the Spanish word for alley. He was from Panama, rarely seen without his wide-brimmed hat and a pair of enormous dark shades covering almost half of his face. Normally he wore a light-coloured suit made of fine yarn, suggesting a warmer climate and fancy leather shoes. Apart from the exotic accent of his clothing, his appearance was very much like the city's venals, It was short, dark and mysterious.
Right, Jack, so what, Jack and Callum, what are you doing?
Just drawing about our ideas about the viaduct, what will attract more people to come and
so what ideas have you put down?
Mine's that the cliff, as you can see behind us, over there, mine's...
Like on TV?
What it is there's a gap in between the rocks, and there's a spiral stair which you kind of see, and they climb to the top and they can see from the cliff top to the viaduct and see what like up there.
Yeah. The final result of mapping the necklace has been an explosion of interest in the Durham Necklace Park, online and on foot, and 20 short films that show some of the many mapping techniques and experiences in the park. Mappers continue to arrive, and the Durham Necklace Park team has co-opted many into helping build the Necklace Park into a community-driven, low-impact success Durham City needs as part of its major process of regeneration.
And so from a park which originally was probably going to be in the city centre, we suddenly felt, no, you can extend this, you can reconnect Durham with its hinterland.